Welcome back, guys. This time I've got a double race video for you. Sunday, I did a Hare Scramble down in Rhode Island, the Wood Chopper. Can't wait to tell you about that. Saturday, to get ready, I did a 5K. Probably not the ideal race prep I was thinking at the time, but guess what? I ran my pace during the race, stuck to my pace, and I caught a lot of people who went out too fast. I ran a decent time, but I used that same racecraft the next day. Check it out.
Let's go, Brandon!
So I was a little late getting to the starting gate, and you can see I have the worst starting position of the entire row. We actually have to go all the way over to the left through a thing that's like 10 bikes wide, so I figure I just wait. And guess what? 50 seconds later, that guy right there on the Kawasaki, I was lined up right next to him at the start. Of course, I then did get stuck behind him. I should have totally hole shotted the guy. I did find it pretty funny, though. I'm glad I was behind him when he ran over this dude. Ouch, man. Rubbin is racing. Okay, so that's Ronald Ardito on the Kawasaki, and Mark Mastret just jumped in on the Beta. He starts screaming at Ardito, like just shouting. So Ardito does the right thing and pulls over. These guys are both in my race, in my class, by the way. I spent a decent amount of the first lap just getting strafed by guys left and right. It was like, you didn't know where they were coming from, and man, they are fast. And then out of nowhere, there's Mastret on the AMP suspension, by the way, but he's in my class. That's a pass for position. Really tight, fun section. That's what it looks like from the outside. I love this stuff, but man, it was crowded. I think I detected a little bit of Doppler effect when that guy went by. That was awesome. Now, there's nowhere to go. I can't pull over. The guy behind me is going out of his mind on the rev limiter. Like, I'm giving you space as soon as I can, buddy. Hey, remember a few seconds ago, we passed Mark Mastret. He yielded to us. Here he is. Same guy. How did I pass? When did he pass me again? I have no idea. Speaking of passing people, check this one out. I thought maybe a little close. Check it out. Yeah, I don't think you can get any closer than that, but you know what? I say that's a clean pass. I got no problem with that, and we will see him again. Yes, we will. Unfortunately for him, just a couple turns down the road, puts it on the ground. He, of course, passes me right back a couple minutes later, and he was flying. But I tell you what, once he got by me, I got a little bit of clean running, and finally was able to just get my own race and my own pace going. So much more comfortable without someone right on your edit, right on your tailpipe, right on your rear fender. Thank you. Now here's William Main again. What's up with that? I think he had a mechanical. I think he actually DNF'd. There was a great climb. This is actually a really steep climb. Doesn't look like it. But man, I could fly up this thing. But of course, me flying has to... doesn't prevent guys from blowing right by me. These were some really nice, easy, clean passes. Coming up in the sandy section, it was a little hairy. I got passed by a freight train, and not in a good way. Train to the end of lap one, where I am in 10th place. Okay. Worst pass of the day goes to a woman with a long blonde ponytail who had plenty of room to go around me and nonetheless hit me. Okay. Cue the screaming. Thank you. So all this close passing, a guy almost put me into a tree, for heaven's sake. It just, it's very unsettling. I end up doing stupid stuff, like taking this line. Like, what? It's like there's a rock garden in the middle of two racing lines. So I go through the rock garden because I don't want to get bombed by, like, another guy. I suppose the simple answer to all this is to just go faster, but man, in the meantime, like, it's tough going and puts me really off my game. You can't get a rhythm going. You know you're not making any time. You gotta keep pulling over like that. That's not the way to be fast. I'm working on it. Coming up to the end of lap two now. Lap two was a lot like lap one, a little bit faster, a little bit less traffic. I think I dropped a spot somewhere. Let me see if I remember that right. Let's see. 11th spot. Yeah, okay. So I dropped one spot. But more importantly, the traffic has really started to thin out. I'm finally just able to race the course instead of kind of having like one ear open all the time so I don't get pushed into a tree or screw up somebody's race, which I don't want to do either one of those things. Finally, I start to get a little momentum going, a little flow. Okay, so that guy skied over that tree trunk and flew right by me. I barely had to lift, I don't think. That's class. Nice move. Pass of the day. Alright, we move now to the part of the race where I actually start passing people. This is Andrew Anthony. He's in B Super Senior. There's a guy right on our ass who cannot wait to get by. I don't know why I didn't take that wide line, but whatever. Point I'm trying to make, I start passing people. Now this guy, okay, is that a pass? I don't know. He waves me by, but I mean, I had to be there, right? And I made it stick. This was a changing of the tide in the race a little bit. I start getting on the gas. This guy, obviously, is faster than both of us, and I'm kind of hanging with him. I think maybe I can do it. We come around a couple turns here. He's got a little bobble. Thinking, you know what? This guy is going to pull me through, take a couple minutes off my lap time, and really start making progress in the race. So here we are. And then this happens. Unfortunate spill for that rider, and we get hung up. That B rider that I just passed is now ahead of me again, and I'm like trying to I see the white boots. I'm focused on that. I know I'm faster than I caught him before. I'm gonna catch him again. Maybe. Possibly. I'm gonna try to pass him sometime in the next 2.5 laps. Please help me. Thank you.
Okay, I'm going at 5K.
Coming into this sandy stuff, he's just ahead of me. He's so close. I can almost get him. Almost. So I made a few stupid mistakes like that one right there, but somehow I actually, that's the guy with the white boots. I've closed the gap to him again. He just turned around and looked. I'm assuming that means I'm about to get past. Yeah, that's right. So he hears that guy. Oh man, I'm pushing hard to get this guy. I'd really like to get by him. Definitely I would like to get by him because he's like the only person I've caught the whole race that wasn't parked. Anyway, we come by the pits here. And this is what it looks like on board. And this is what it looks like when the pros do it. Yeah, so obviously I'm not Brian Dussault. He actually went on to win the Hare Scramble Championship this year. Pretty amazing. But I've caught the white boots man, and my relentless pressure has cracked him. And he's just going to pull over and wave me by. I assume that means there's somebody behind me pegged on the rev limiter, and he's just, whatever. I got the position, didn't give it back, got the white flag, and now I'm in 12th. Not great. Just up the trail here, we take a left, and that guy off on the right-hand side in the blue, that's Brian Dussault. He's given a little trail direction. Here he is in his race, kicking some ass. Man, I could definitely use some good luck myself. Ugh, coming over the brow here, the trail splits. You can go the high way where that guy just went to the left, or low way to the right. Let's see, what do? I go the high way this time. I started taking the low way later. That seemed to be better. Let's watch Dussault and the number two guy, Nick Cordona, do it. Dussault will be by in just a second here. All right, that's Dussault, and you see he makes kind of a late decision to take that lower route. Man, that guy's just flying. He had a huge lead, and this is Cordona, the guy who finished second in the championship right here. Let's see what he does. All right, so it looks like Cordona goes the high line. A lot of style points there. Oh, some advice from Dad? Yeah, stay on the outside. I don't know. I think the lower line was better. This part of the race, definitely the flow is here for me. I got guys passing me. I can hear them behind me, but I'm starting to catch people too and stay with people. It felt pretty good. Let's see how this guy does with his pass. Seems like I get the whoops right like two times out of five or two times out of four, but you know, it's that one you get wrong that's gonna put you into the trees. I was used to the 200 again. There's a lot less traffic. I can kind of ride my own race, and I'm catching people like this guy. This guy, right? He was ahead of me way back here at this thing. So I've now caught and passed that guy. I'm riding like I know I can ride. I'm really enjoying this. Now you might remember a couple of minutes ago, there was a guy who passed me jumping over a blowdown. There's the blowdown on the right. I'm coming around here on the main trail, and he just sails over that thing. Okay, I had to swerve a little bit on that tree, but a really nice pass. Here I am. I'm going to take the line he took right over here, right? I'm gonna sky right over that same log, just like he. Oh. Okay, I didn't sail over it by any means. That was pretty embarrassing. But I recovered quickly, and I gotta say, it didn't slow me down much. Kept the hammer down, and I tell you what, guys, that was not the last person I'm gonna catch. I mean, I'm pushing, and I feel great. Okay, once again, target acquired. However, once again, remember this is C super senior, so nothing happens really fast. Anyway, I take the cutoff route and get around that guy. Another one in the books. I'm not done. Oh, this is that uphill that I just loved. This thing was awesome. This is like when the predators target the wounded in the pack. This guy, he's got 1 foot off the peg, and then I'm like, this guy, I gotta pass this guy before the line. And then after the race, I checked his number, it's Tom Levesque. He finished third place in Masters, which means he's over 60. So he's just like amazing for an over 60 rider. It's all I can do to get past him. Sure who that guy was. He signals me to pass right, and I checked the results. I'm not totally sure. I think that might have been a pass for position, which is amazing because we're right getting close to the line here, and that guy was just waving people by. Here we are, the last little dash through the motocross section. I'm freaking out. I'm like, please, please, please let me not screw up and lose any of those passes I made. We'll check over the shoulder. Things look pretty clear. Should be able to wrap it up from here. Little shoot to the checkered flag. I managed to hold on to all those passes. Happy to see the checkered flag. It says I finished 13th. Final results had me in 12th out of 20. And looking at the lap times, that's exactly where I should have been. Got faster and faster during the day, but obviously need to go out harder at the beginning and maybe not have to deal with quite so much traffic. On to the next one, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, and we'll see you soon. Come on, bro.